Steve Hinton, flying the P-51 Wee Willie 2 from the Planes of Fame Air Museum in Chino, California. You know, I had a fortunate upbringing growing up around warbirds and airplanes from a young age. And initially, as a kid, you don't know anything different. But definitely as I grew older, I realized what a fortunate position I was in. And you know, I had several, 20 or 30 different aunts and uncles growing up around the airport. And everyone kind of looked out for me as I wandered off. I get a lot of satisfaction from working on aircraft. Flying it is definitely an enjoyable experience, but that's such a short part of really what the airplane does, and you spend more time turning wrenches and understanding what makes them tick, and being able to fly in the airplane and feel a little vibration or it sounds a little funny, and then go right into diagnosing that and fixing it. It's a very rewarding full circle experience. Flying at Reno is a complete unique experience. I can't relate it to anything else in aviation. When you're 50 feet off the ground, going 500 miles an hour, but then your head's also in the cockpit looking at a dozen different steam gauges, and then twiddling valves, flying formation, or it's a thrill that's unlike anything else. Initially, the very first time going around the pylons, there's so much, it's information overload. In the first lap, I think we pulled off the course and, did I forget to call for the qualifying time, or? It happens so quickly, and after a couple of years, you're really able to slow down and process all the information coming at you, and you can look, there's two blue porta potties at pylon 3, and there's only one at pylon 4, different colors of sagebrush. So it's a tremendous experience, and it's incredible. Unique race, in going through that because it was a Saturday race, you're always trying to get to Sunday anyway, so we just ran a prescribed power setting, and I remember coming around pylon 7 and pylon 8 and looking down, and I could see a shadow. It didn't surprise me that he was there, but it was neat looking down and seeing two shadows. But it was definitely a thrill for the crowd, and that was a lot of fun getting to be able to race against Tiger. My experience at Reno really came down to timing, being in the right place at the right time, and having the opportunity from Tiger and then Bob Button. Growing up, my dad obviously raced, but then Lyle and Tiger and Skip Holm, John Penny, those guys were, for me, idols growing up, and then being able to fly in that same venue was incredible. Great equipment and great crews that supported the airplane, and fortunate. Flying with the Air Force is a tremendous honor, and it really is a privilege. It's been a full circle experience for me. I wanted to go to the Air Force Academy growing up through high school and went to a summer seminar. It didn't work out for a couple of reasons here and there, but to be able to now come full circle and fly alongside with current Air Force jets, and like you said, the pilots and the maintainers are all about the same age. It's really a camaraderie, and this teamwork is just incredible.